Senator Cory Gardner, Republican from Colorado, who sits on the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. Senator, it's good to have you here. Should Congress, you know, take a look at who the president might nominate? Or, you know, should they go on the record with any of this? Or should they do what Senator Mitch McConnell is saying?
Well, the Constitution is very clear. The president has a right to nominate a Supreme Court justice, and the Senate has the right to advice and consent of that nominee. And so I believe, as many of my colleagues do, that the next president, the will of the American people should be heard. The next president should make that determination of who our next justice of the Supreme Court should be.
Well, even though it is in the Constitution that President Obama has the right to put a name forward now, it's my understanding the White House has invited Senator Grassley to consult on the SCOTUS nominee, Republican, but that Grassley has not answered. Would you think that Grassley should go consult about this or just not answer?
Well, look, we're deep in the heart of an election. We just had caucuses in Nevada yesterday. You've got Super Tuesday coming up well into this election. The American people are deciding who it's going to be. Is it going to be President Rubio? Is it going to be President Sanders? The bottom line is the American people in just a few months are going to make that determination, and that's who I believe is best suited to decide who the next Supreme Court justice should be.
Okay. House Speaker Paul Ryan says Republicans are taking steps to stop President Obama now from closing Gitmo and relocating dozens of detainees, possibly to facilities here in the United States. So take a look at this map now. The Department of Defense scouted a few potential sites that could house those detainees, and there are numerous military bases and installations in close proximity to densely populated areas of Pueblo and Colorado Springs in your home state, Senator, of Colorado. Maybe not a lot of people understand how close these detainee facilities, prisons, would be to bases and to lots of people.
Look, 7 of the 13 supposed sites that we have heard about are located in Colorado. But the facilities where they're looking at, many in Florence, Colorado, are just miles away from the Pueblo Chemical Depot in Pueblo, Colorado. That's mustard gas, our legacy of previous wars. They're just miles away from Colorado Springs. I was just last week out at Northcom, our Homeland Defense Northcom base in Colorado Springs at Peterson Air Force Base. NORAD, everybody remembers Cheyenne Mountain from the movie War Games. That's not too far away from where this facility is located. The Air Force Academy is just down the road from this facility. And look, these are people who could be transferred if they're removed and from Guantanamo Bay, relocated in Florence, Colorado. They could be put on the highways, put in downtown Denver. And I know from the sheriffs who have objected to this plan as well, that they actually saw tremendous security risks when the Oklahoma City bombing trials took place in downtown Denver. And now they want to put Guantanamo Bay detainees there. I think it's an unacceptable risk to the people of Colorado and this country.
All right. Senator Cory Gardner weighing in on the Gitmo situation. Thank you. This woman's family just won a seven.